fine addition to your collection this figure will be, that's for sure. We finally get a General Grievous 6-inch Black Series figure, and he is quite a sight to behold. A very cool looking figure indeed. And just to give you an idea, next to there's a Marvel Legends figure, which is a little bit bigger, but just for scale, he's pretty much on the money. He's a little bit reduced in size, I think, but look, there'll be an endless argument over size and what we can do with that. There he is next to Bossk, for example, just to give you another bit of a size. So he's a pretty big figure overall, standing in at just under 7 inches tall. So we finally get one. I mean, my God, it's taken so long, so many figures in and we get one. And it's, is it worth the wait? Well, yes, there's a couple of niggles, but that's to be expected pretty much. Nothing is perfect, but we'll get a look at him in just a second. Picked up at DarkSideToys.com. If you want to buy it, there's a link in the description below. I think they might be sold out by now. And definitely some are shipping. I'm seeing some groups and forums, which is great. And I think, to be honest, they're one of the few places that's actually got them right now. There's a lot of scalpers on Amazon, eBay. Just so be patient. If you haven't pre-ordered it yet, well, maybe you should have. But I certainly know they will have some stock they've mentioned that will be at Celebration. So if you want to get it for a good price and you're going to Celebration, you can get one there if you're quick. So let's get a look at the packaging. We get some very nice Gregory Titus artwork on the box. Very much squeezed in down at the bottom in a very small area, which is a bit of a shame because his artwork really is stupendous. Look at the kind of eyes there. It's just so well done, his line drawings. I am a huge fan these days. And of course, Star Wars The Black Series up at the top. Logo and, sorry, the text on the side. As usual, there's the UPC, should you need it, and don't stick it up your nose stuff. Number D1. He is the one you want. I like it. Like the numbering. So there we go. This is Deluxe One. Even though we've actually had Deluxe, we've actually had the Gamorrean Guard and other characters from Solo, etc., that were Target exclusives that were Deluxe figures. But this is the first labelled Deluxe One. General Grievous, some text there in various languages. Again, nothing you don't know. It's just general stuff. But we do get more of that gorgeous artwork on the side, and that is it. So pretty standard box for the figure. Just for going to Grievous himself, we're going to look at him in just a tick. Comes with a very cool blaster. Come on, camera, don't pee me about. There we go. Oh, it's just not liking the focus there. Come on, focus on this. There we go. So we get pretty good detail on this blaster. Let me give that a little bit more light. And we get some lovely kind of silvery chrome, kind of gold up at the top. It looks like there's almost a two-tone goldy silver color. It's a weird one. I've not seen this before. But we really do get some metallic looking stuff on that. And it just looks all the better for it. It really picks up all the little minute details you can see around the handle, just where the finger grip is, and up here, just these little grills and pieces. It's beautiful. What a difference paint can make. And again, normally if this is just solid black, you just wouldn't see it. But we'll get to more of this blaster coming up shortly. Now, Grievous comes with 4 lightsabers, which we'll get a look at in just a minute. But let's take these off and really get a look at the figure. Now, one of the things, first of all, which is slightly disappointing, was the fact that the cape wasn't quite what we were promised. The material's slightly different. We also do not get the Mando symbol, not the Mando symbol, sorry, the Grievous kind of symbol on the back of the cape, which at one point I thought we were getting. But we're not getting it. The other part that's lovely on this cape, it's really nice, is we do get on one side. Now, Grievous does have it on both. He had pockets on both, I believe. But we do get a little stitch piece there for the lightsaber hilts, which it was briefly in the movie. All of the lightsabers are detachable. You can take these off. There's a little double plug on them. You can see that really grips into them. And they can then be put into his cape as such, so you can display them like that if you want to. The one letdown with the cape is, why go to all that bother and not stitch the bottom? Little bit cheap, Hasbro. You really could have. It's a deluxe figure, you're paying extra money for it. Why could you not stitch it? I know, you're stitching all the other areas. This was money. This was money, I guarantee you. This was money that stopped that, and maybe getting it kind of lined like this, but That was money, and that's a real shame. It's a real, real shame. However, it might not bother you. Does it bother you? Leave a note in the comment and let us know. So the cape also has stitching here up at the top, and it's incredibly thick. So it's really quite, it's nice in one way that it's thick and displays around his shoulders really well. It's kind of tucked into the back here. Let me see if we can try and remove this a little. It seems to be that it's, I don't think it's glued in. There we go, it's kind of placed in. There you go. So we can take this off and we can get a better look at the figure. There we go. So a stitched on piece. It's a shame there was no little buckle that he had there, that little piece in the movie, remember? So you can faff around with this and do what you want to. But it, like, you know, it's a pretty reasonable cloak. I am sure we've not seen the last of Grievous. I bet we will get another Grievous in some time with extra details in the cloak or something. Give it time. On with the figure. So, I mean, they've really went to town here in terms of the detail. First of all, that face, the eyes, we've really captured the eyes there. We've got some glossy paint in the eye sockets themselves, which give that moist fleshiness that his original species had, if you know the backstory and had the original figure from a way back in 3.75 inch. We get nice touches of silver on the mouthpiece, done in a very kind of staccato fashion down the kind of lines of these pulse like pieces on his mouth, so that adds some real detail to it, which is really nice. And the groove lines on his face are done really well too, with a little bit of wearing and scarring on that face. It's pretty awesome. You can almost hear the laugh coming out of it there. So I do like this a lot. Now that is on a little, we'll do articulation as we go through the figure because there's a lot of articulation on this guy. That's on a little ball joint away up in that head. So you get really good movement pretty much all over. Now on top of that, we then have, you can just about see it in there. It's a kind of, there's extra pieces there that aren't quite connected to things. But what we do have is a kind of like joystick piece. And in that center is really hard to see inside there. We've got a little ball joint inside there, and that allows you to have this little, as I say, joystick-like piece. Think of it like a game controller you're playing, like a PS4 or something, or a thumb controller, or a Nintendo Switch. That's what it's like, and it works really well. So they've added these extra pieces, these pipes, just as cut-off pieces, but just tuck them in there, and that allows that to just move around like cables without it causing any fuss or being attached. So it gives you extra articulation. You can see up at the top there, there's little ball joints for these shoulders. Now, be very careful. These little joints here are quite flimsy. I can clearly see there's some issue there that someone's going to get some broken joints here. You'll notice that some of the joints, I think some of it is paint, but in some areas, particularly around here on this little elbow, that is articulation. But I think when I initially took it out the packaging, I didn't realise, and I moved it just a little bit too harshly, and that plastic is now a little bit whiter, which means it's a little bit softer, a little bit thinner. So these joints are a little bit fragile. Be careful. Now the same goes for these shoulders up there. There are two joints, as you can see, because really he does have four arms, so they all have separate articulation. It's a little bit hard to show underneath here. These pieces, which were very annoying on the 3.75 inch figure, look to be not articulated but glued in, which is quite nice. And we've got some very nice kind of bone scarring going on the figure too. On the back, you'll see the little seams and the notches around the figure. They look particularly good. Even the back of his head looks good. The grey paint's pretty basic throughout. There's not a lot of extra love put in there. You can see some little splashes of silver, but it really could have done with a lot more to accentuate all the kind of pipes and things, but it's a little hard to do all of that at the cost point, I think. But we do get some nice, the bone work, this armour plating that he has, has got some lovely brown kind of detail and all sorts of stuff around there too, so very nice indeed. His chest plate you can kind of stretch open a little bit, and there's what would have been his heart piece in the middle there. So I think we'll get another figure in time with a dying Grievous. I think you'll get to see it. Just mark my words, you can come back and tell me if I'm right or wrong. But these two little, or four little joins up at the top here, are again quite fragile, so be careful of how you move them. They're independent, and they're ball joints on these hinges, so they allow the figure to be pretty much moved up in any way you want. And again, extra articulation like so. Again, be careful. There's another one I've kind of stretched on that joint. Someone's going to snap these and not be too happy. But as you can see, You're going to get some great poses with Grievous. I mean, it's pretty damn good. It's a very technically challenging figure to do. On top of that, you can see we've got a swivel joint up here. I think it's a ball, but you can barely get in there. But that allows the arms to move up as well, so you can have even more kind of articulation there. So you can have no problem with this guy. You can just about see it under there. You're no problem with this guy to really get some great poses with out of him. So that's what we wanted, and that's what we're getting. Now, on top of that, there is an upper ab crunch. You can just see it there. I think it's just a ball joint, again, up the top, which is giving you a limited amount forward and a limited amount back because of the armor piece is there. I wonder if I move that, can we get a little further back? Yeah, maybe you can, actually. It's just the armor seems to be getting in the way. This glued piece, maybe if we move it back a little. Anyway, futz around with it, but it doesn't look you're going to get too much, but you certainly get some movement to the right and some movement to the left. It's, yeah, there's a little piece, there you go. So you can pretty much get a full movement around. It's pretty amazing. Again, technically, what a difficult figure to make. Down to a ball joint up at the top of these thighs, you can see, and again, more nice little silver paint. See the difference that makes? Just to the kind of making it more metallic. But they've obviously had to go light on that because of costs, but beautifully done. Double jointed knees on this guy. Very cool. And done with a kind of a click-like feeling or motion. There's something clicking in there and it makes it feel pretty good. Now the legs are quite solid, so you'll get plenty of movement on them as it moves throughout. And again, that second knee, so plenty of movement all on there. We also get a little, look at that, this is nuts. A swivel here, which is just insane. And then down at the bottom here, a little bit difficult to see, but there is plastic in there that's a little bit, you know, sometimes you get plastic that's a little bit rough and it's kind of hard to see, but you can actually bend that back. So again, be careful too. These are not the biggest and toughest joints, but not only have you got the swivel, but there is a hinge in there to go back and forth. But you need to apply a bit of pressure. There is no peg holes, which is a real shame because that is the only other key flaw with this figure. I think the figure is flawless. I think the cape has the flaw because of the missing seam and the pattern on the back. And the joins, I mean, they're understandably very thin, but the other flaw, which I've completely forgotten as I was talking about, was the... What was I talking about? The cape? Oh, well, they've forgotten the flaw, so there you go. Is the joins is, I think, particularly the issue there that you have. Now, these arms, they connect together, so you can have them splicing together. And if I move that in, and you'll see that plugs in there too. This is a complicated figure, man. This is review's taking a long time. And also, you have a little plug point there. So three plug points for every arm to join it to make it one. Still remember that articulation, you have to move pretty carefully. But that allows you to connect those arms. And that is pretty solid. He's a rocking figure. Let's go look at the lightsabers very quickly. There are four in the pack. Two green and two with a kind of very pale blue purple. And he holds them exceptionally well. There is no issue whatsoever for these. So very thick, very heavy lightsabers. I'm just kind of rolling through them all there. All different designs. But very much thick, again, which allows him to hold them very well. And again, they all unplug very easily. Just unplug that off. You see those little peg pieces there, and again that allows you to display them inside the cape or not. Beautiful. It's a really cool figure. Again, he holds them very well. And the blaster, that was the point I was going to try and make, was again, just watch when you bend these elbows, you got to bear in mind they're bending independently even though they're one. That's why you get that little white plastic there. However, in his hand you can, once you get the two together eventually, come on, as you futz about with it, there you go, you can get him to grip it. So there you go, pretty good. He looks astonishing. You got to play around with this one for a long time and get the poses, but General Grievous, mega thumbs up. Very, very good figure. Link in the description below to buy it. Long review, but there's a lot of detail in this guy, and I cannot wait to see everybody's poses that everyone will have him in. That's it for me. We'll see you for the next in the Black Series line coming right up after this video.